Well, the attorney defending Nicholas Coker says the parents of the young girl had asked him to babysit on several occasions for hours at a time. And until this allegation, he was considered by many, including neighbors, to be a peaceful man who was very good with children. Prosecutors say 21-year-old Nicholas Coker told the mother of a 4-year-old he was babysitting that the two had been making faces at each other when he first noticed blood spots in her eyes and on her face and neck. It was later at the emergency room that the young victim herself allegedly told her mother and ER staff what happened.
During which she describes the defendant getting angry at her, grabbing her by the throat with his hand, lifting her off the ground. She indicated she was unable to breathe during that incident. He then put her down on the floor and proceeded to lean over her and shove his fingers down her throat, causing her to continue to experience impeded breathing.
According to the state, Coker, who lived in the same Rochester apartment complex as the girl and her parents, later gave conflicting stories to police.
He denied knowing how these injuries occurred to the child, and then later in the interview indicated that he has an anger management problem and has difficulty dealing with his anger, and that he blacks out and is not sure what exactly happens.
In appealing for a change in bail, Coker's attorney says his client has been dealing with mental health issues since he was 18 months old, but has no history of violence, that he has a great relationship with his parents, had moved out on his own, and had a new doctor.
They tried a new medication regimen that his parents observed. Did not appear to be sitting well, was having some adverse reactions.
Coker's bail remains at $10,000, but the judge added a surety measure to that as well as a mental health referral. If he does get out on bail, he's required to live with his parents and not have contact with anyone under the age of 16. Reporting live in Portsmouth, Jennifer Crompton, WMUR News 9.